And the next slide is on the ingredients of a valid contract. So it is not only for contract of employment, for any valid contract, there must be an offer, and that offer must be accepted, right, by the other party. And the parties to the contract, they must have the capacity to enter into a contract. When we say capacity to enter into contract, they must be, if they are individuals, if they happen to be individuals, then they must be more than 18 years of age. So because less than 18, as far as India is concerned, they are treated as minor. A minor cannot enter into a contract. If at all, if that is to be done, then on behalf of the minor, the guardian of the minor has to sign in the contract. Only then the contract will become valid, right? And the fourth ingredient is the consensus ad idem, which means consent for the terms and conditions by both the parties. So the both the parties should give their consent for the terms and conditions, whatever is written down in the contract. Maybe in our case, it is a contract of employment, and there must be a consideration. So in our case, again, the consideration is the salary part, right? It could be monthly grass, or it could be CTC. It is possible. And legality. So the purpose for which that person is engaged, or the purpose for which the contract is entered into, should be legally valid, right? So you cannot enter into a contract with another person to murder a third person, right? Or to injure a third person. It is not possible because it is a crime, right? So the purpose for which the other person or the contract is entered into should be legally valid as per the existing laws of the land, as well as the laws which could emanate maybe on a subsequent period. And of course, the final one is the possibility of performance, right? So there must be, you cannot come up with a condition or class which is impossible to perform. It is not possible. Suppose if you are asking a person to fly and come, no, it is not possible, right? It is not humanly possible, at least. So that will be treated as invalid then. So offer, acceptance, competency of the parties to enter into contract, and the consensus ad idem, the consideration, legality, the possibility of performance are all the ingredients for a valid contract, not only for the contract of employment. It is very general. It is for any contract, right? This is the case. And of course, coming to our specific subject, contract of employment, who can make the offer, right? So in a company, yes, starting from the managing director or the chairman, a person who is authorized by the board, right, he can issue the offer. So it could be a manager, or it could be a person in the board, right? So only the authorized person can make an offer on behalf of the company, and the authorization should be very specific. There must be a very clear board resolution, right? So only those persons can make the offer to the persons. Then that person will become automatically the employee.